Hello guys, welcome back to my gaming PC series. Today we will be taking a look at the best and fastest $600 gaming PC that I think we can currently build. And we break this video down into two parts. First, we're gonna go over all the parts and why we picked them. And then we will test multiple games to see how well this gaming PC actually does. As always, I made sure that all the hardware parts fit perfectly together so that we don't waste any money on things that we don't really need. And of course, this channel is not sponsored by anybody and neither is this video, so I'm completely free of bias and can really recommend what I think is the best hardware that we can currently buy. But now, let's not waste any more time and let's dive directly into the parts for our $600 gaming PC build. First, in my opinion, the best processor in this price segment is the AMD Ryzen 3 3100. It has 4 cores with 8 threads and up to 3.9 GHz, which is really good even for today's incredibly high standards. But this processor is not only quite powerful, but it also is extremely cheap with just about $115. In Cinebench, where professionals usually test CPU performances, we can also see that this CPU gets really good results for such low amount of money with 2,298 points. And when it comes to the single core test, the results are also very good because we score 447 points, which is even better than some higher tier Ryzen processors. The temperatures during all the benchmarks and game tests were also very stable, and that means that the stock cooler that is included is pretty good and we don't need to waste any money on an extra cooler, which is very cost efficient. The Ryzen 3 3100 is also more cost efficient than all Ryzen 5 CPUs at the moment, and it provides a better single core performance even compared to the Ryzen 5 2600, which is also an awesome CPU with great value. And so I think, given that single core performance is critical for playing games, that the Ryzen 3 3100 is the best value CPU in this price segment at the moment. Of course, we not only need a strong CPU, but also a great graphics card, as that part is really the heart and soul of any gaming PC. And for our $600 build, I think the best graphics card that we can currently buy is the GeForce GTX 1660 Super. For my build specifically, I prefer the GeForce GTX 1660 Super OC version with 6GB from Gigabyte. But the difference between the different versions from different vendors is not really significant, so you could just buy the version that's cheapest in your area. By the way, I will leave the links to all the available 1660 Super versions in the description of this video. But anyways, this GPU is a real powerhouse. For the performance you get here, you had to spend about $500 5 years ago. But now you can get that for just slightly above $200, which is pretty nice. But despite the decent price, it has everything that we need. It has 6GB of memory with almost 830 MHz memory clock. It is VR ready and it gave us a great frame rate in all the games that I tested. Of course, we also need a solid motherboard that perfectly supports our Ryzen 3. And therefore, I recommend the MSI B450M Pro VDH-Max. This motherboard perfectly supports the Ryzen 3 together with the necessary frequencies, the AM4 socket and the third generation compatibility. Now, this is an area where a lot of custom builders really make costly mistakes. Don't ever buy the most expensive motherboards. It's like buying an expensive Tesla with an engine that can only drive 50 miles per hour. It might look amazing, but it doesn't make you any faster. For the motherboard, it's sufficient to support all the necessary frequencies and to have all the connectors that we need. And that's exactly the case here. However, at the same time, this motherboard is also one of the cheapest ones out there. And so by buying this one, you can really save yourself a lot of money. When it comes to the memory, we want to equip one of the two RAM slots with an 8GB RAM block from Corsair with 3200 MHz. This is a really fast RAM and the built-in XMP 2.0 support ensures trouble-free and automatic overclocking. It also perfectly fits the Ryzen 3 specification, making this a must-have for our build. By the way, if you have some money left to spend, the first thing I would do in order to further upgrade this build would be to buy a second 8GB RAM block. 16GB of RAM are great and using RAM in dual channel mode also provides a small additional speed boost. For the memory, we again rely on the classic PNY CS900 with 240GB SSD. It's really important to buy SSDs nowadays instead of HDDs because SSDs are almost as cheap as the old HDDs but much, much faster. So in this case, you actually get the real Tesla but for the price of an old Beetle. And in order for the system to always be reliably and quietly supplied with power, we use the Corsair CV450 with 8+ bronze certification, all the necessary protection circuits, multi-rail and DC-DC technology. And in the end, all the components are installed in an aero-cool Cylon. It's a really inexpensive mid-tower case where you have a lot of space for future upgrades like HDDs or even complete system upgrades. However, when it comes to the case, you may choose the different one because it doesn't really affect any performance and it's mostly personal preference of what's looking good. Of course, you can find the links to all the parts I mentioned in the description of this video. So if you are interested in some or all of them, you can find them there. And of course, you can find this build and the builds for all other price categories on my homepage. They are updating all the builds regularly, so if you watch this video a few months from now, then you can always go there and you will find all the latest builds with guaranteed best value for money. By the way, before we dive into the game test, I would love if you gave this video a thumbs up because it helps out my channel quite a lot. And it also helps me to continue making these videos. Also, if you like this video series, you can always subscribe to my channel and click the bell so that you don't miss out on future videos. But now, let's jump into the benchmarks and game tests. Of course, I have tested this gaming PC in the 3D Mark TimeSpy benchmark and then in multiple games. In 3D Mark TimeSpy, this build scores 5,902 overall points. The graphic score is 6,263 and the CPU score is 4,452. That's actually pretty solid, especially the GPU scores are quite good. As games in general do need more GPU resources, this gaming PC seems to be pretty balanced. And now that we got all the numbers and statistics out of the way, please enjoy the game tests. Oh, we're still here, flipping coins about what's to come. It starts getting cold, and we don't know any way out of here. We try to understand how it all started to go wrong. But the sea is way too deep, yeah, it's deep.
You're not afraid. You make me wanna run like a kid. sleep even if I knew that I should. It made me lonely and bitter, but that was all before you. Now we be staying up all night. We don't have to sleep cause we're crazy in love. Oh,
even now these were all the game tests. So overall I would say that if you want to copy this gaming PC build, you will definitely have a lot of fun playing lots of games at very high settings. Anyways, I hope you guys found this video very helpful. If you do so, you can always leave a like to show some support. And of course, if you're new to this channel, you can also subscribe so that you can always easily find some great gaming PC builds that are optimized for game performance and price.